Hello explorers and welcome to another video. Today we're going to talk about Singularity. And Singularity is a container system that is very similar to Docker and it can use Docker sometimes. First off, we're going to look at how you build containers. And containers can be built in the same way as you do in Docker. You can have a definition file and then build your Docker container. But you can also do it by actually starting a container in an operating system and then working with that container in a writable mode in order to create your container structure. And this is very interesting. So first off here, we're going to create a sandbox that we can play around in. So this command will create a sandbox in the directory Ubuntu and we'll use the image Ubuntu in order to create that sandbox. So when we run this, we need to run it as root in order to actually hook up to the system. And it starts building, it will download the current image and put this image on my machine. And you see here, this image is quite small. It's just 26 megabytes. So it's compact and it's easy to work with. So that was a really fast way to create a little sandbox. And then I can go into this sandbox like this. I execute it with writable permissions and using Ubuntu and bin bash. So now I am in my environment here. The important part to know when you are in a Singularity container is that your home directory and your root directory is actually bound to your local computer. So if you start a Singularity container and do something in the root directory, you will have direct access to that directory. The same goes for if you are a specific user in the sandbox, you can also go to your home directory and actually get information from there. And the first thing we're going to do in this environment is update our local package registry, so it will download everything from the internet and update so we have all the latest packages. Now that that's done, we will install the Maven dependencies and open JDK 11. So now when I have actually installed these two dependencies, I will head over to the opt directory in my guest system. So this is one of the directories that are not mounted to my host system. So here I can do things inside of the image. And here I will create an archetype with my Maven project. So this is a simple archetype, a quick application. So there I have a quick Maven application with a POM file and all the basics that you need in order to play around with Maven. So if we go into this basics directory here, we see that we have a source directory and a POM file. So I will do Maven package here. So I will actually build my application. That means that I will have a basic application that I can later run outside of my environment. So now we will exit out from this. I will do Control D and that will run me out to the host system again. So now I'm not inside of my Singularity environment. Here I can take this directory, so the Ubuntu directory, as you see as the last argument here, and I will create a work sif, and sif is a Singularity image file. So I will build an image file from this Ubuntu directory that I used earlier in a writable mode. So this directory is a file system with everything that you need in order to run your system, and then you take that and package it up into an image file. So that's a very interesting way to work with it. So you run your guest system from a directory and have read-write access to that directory, and later on you will build that into a specific image file. So now I have built this sif file, and then I can just go on and run this sif file. So here I will have a command where I execute, Singularity execute this work sif file, and within this sif file I will run the Java in the guest system, find this jar file and put that in my class path and run my application. And when I do that, I get hello world out to the screen. So this is a very interesting way, I think, to interactively create your instances. So we can go in here to the Ubuntu directory, and here you see that you actually have an environment for Singularity. You have a root, you don't have a root directory, and that's because it will mount to your root directory on your system. And so here we can see that we have this installed environment, and you can work with it in a writable way. So that's the first way I wanted to show you. Next up, we're going to look into this Singularity directory here. We can see here that we can build things not just from a directory interactively. We can run this little command here, run build a new SIF file and from a definition file. And if we run this last command here, that will actually use the SIF file and run it. So it will take the SIF file and run the local instance of Java in the SIP file, which is a Maven package, which is similar to the build that we just did. And you see that this works fine as well. It will get hello world. So now let's look at this definition file. Let's see how it actually works. I will not run the build because it just takes time and it's not interesting to look at. So here, first off, I will bootstrap this. So I can bootstrap it with either Docker images or S-Hub images, so from Singularity Hub. But I chose to start with a Docker image. And this Docker image is Ubuntu, the latest version. Then we have this pre tag here. So everything starts with the percent sign. So this pre tag over here, it will run things on your host before you start installing things. I'm not really sure why you want to do that. And here you can run stuff on your host as well after you've done the installation of the image. So these, I think, are very unusual to actually use because they don't work inside of the guest system, in the image. And then when you have installed Ubuntu, so after install in the guest system, then you have this post step. And this is interesting. Here we can do all the things that we want. So I want to update the system as we did before. I want to install the dependencies that we want. And then I go into this basic directory here, and I will do Maven package in that directory. And you might wonder, what is this basic directory? Yeah, that's because down here we have a files directive. And here I can say that the basic directory that I have on my system will be copied over to the opt directory. So this will be done after the installation, but before the post step. So then we will have the files already in the system. Then you have a test step here. This is interesting because this is something that you can run on the image. You can say test this image, and it will run these test steps on the environment. And it requires that it returns zero, so it exits on zero, or else it will actually say that this image is not correct. It's not a valid image. So you can actually add some test cases here if you want. Run script, that is something that is run when you run the image. So you saw earlier that I ran the image, and this is the command that will actually be executed when I run the image. On the other hand, if I start the image as an instance, for instance, in a Docker environment or anything like that, when it runs as an instance, then it will run this start script. So that's different from the run script. So you can have two different use cases for either running things or for starting the script. Then we have some labels, and these can be shown if you inspect this image. You ask it what are you all about, and here you can put a lot of information. In my case, I just put author, but you can say the version number and so on. So you can inspect an image and get more information about who built it, when was it built, and so on. Then we have environment, and this is where you put all your environment variables. It's a name value pair, and these will be set up in the system when you are working in it. And last but not least, you have a help section. So if you run help on the image, this is what will be printed out in that section. So here you can put useful information about how to run this instance, how to set it up in a Docker environment, and so on, if you want to ship it to someone that needs to set it up in their system. Last but not least, I want to talk a little bit about how to install Singularity on your system. And Singularity is packaged with many distributions, so you might already have it. If you want to build it from source, then you can follow instruction on their site. And I did that. It was not that many steps. You needed to download Go because it's written in Go. It used a dependency manager called dep from Go, so you can install all the dependencies required to actually install this system. And then you just go into the Singularity directory and build that instance, and it will be installed to your system. So it's not that many steps, it's not that hard. But it depends on which environment you are running in. I tried to install this in Windows, for instance, and the Windows installer was a little bit janky. It didn't work on Windows 7. It seems only to work in Windows 10 or within Windows systems where you have a PowerShell that is version 3 or later. So I thought it was easier to run this in a virtual box on my system to show you how it works. I think Singularity has a lot going for it. It's very similar to Docker, and you can deploy things to a Docker environment. I don't think that it has as much traction as Docker has, but I think the scripts in this system is very interesting. And I just showed you the very basics today. There is a lot of other configuration that you can do in Singularity. You can build different apps that are in a single image. So you can actually package and 3-4 applications in one image. And that's a very interesting use case. I can see that I can use Singularity in cases where, for instance, I have an application in my Linux system that I don't want to install in my system. I might just want it to have it in a single instance. Then I might set up a Singularity instance as it's just 28 megabytes for the actual image, and then I can build this image with all the dependencies that are required to run that specific application, run it when I need it, and then just put it aside, and it will not be fully baked into my system with all the dependencies and so on. I hope you found this video interesting. I hope you learned something today. Give this video a like, share it with your friends and colleagues. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the comment section down below. If you haven't subscribed yet, please do that. And I really hope to see you in the next video.